born, I've been ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe, with a cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew, yeah. Ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay, yeah, yeah.
Can I hit that?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerge from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Miami Dolphins. 2-1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500, and we are underway here in week three. Thompson. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled at the 30.
The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field of the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
A good run got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Minshew quickly completing it out wide. And some space here. He's at the 40. Past the 20. Touchdown, Jaguars. Keelan Cole, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Jags have taken the early lead.
Josh Lambeau lining up for the point after.
Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. 2 plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms, because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up 1st and 10 at the 20. This to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Breida, the Dolphin ball.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on 1st down.
And some room to work. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Run there by Matt Breida, and he spent the early part of his career in San Francisco sharing the backfield and sharing the ball. What you really want with him, open space and make sure he's touching it, because he can take it from zero to the end zone in a very short amount of time.
Howard, the ball carrier. A gain of three, second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front, so if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
And he is close to a first down as he's tackled at the Jaguars 41. 7 yards there and a first down. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
5 yards remain on second down.
Jaguars 36-yard line.
Tua going to hand this one to Breida. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. They lost four there, and it's third down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. On first down, here's Breida. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
A gain of 2.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits. Everyone was in the right place.
And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line.
Joe Schobert.
It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. Counter with Breida, and he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida, his 5th touchdown now on the year, and the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
On second down, Minshew. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 15 yards on the play, first down.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get an advantage that way.
Minshew, first and 10. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And bulldozing his way through. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Shotgun handoff to Thompson, and he'll be taken down at the 34. Tackle made there by Eric Rowe.
No doubt about it, a really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and 9, Minshew. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Looking to throw it, Minshew. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the 1 yard line.
1 yard line. They gave up excellent real estate on that one. That's going to work really, really well for the guys who threw it.
They'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
To second and goal at the Dolphins' 4-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. First carry for Carlos Hyde. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They'll come out in the pistol. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. The ball's loose.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
A 29-yard attempt.
And Lambeau will put this one through, and the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. They had it first and goal, 3 attempts, couldn't get it in, so they settle for 3.
Yeah, the field tends to shrink a little bit the closer you get to the goal line, doesn't it? It doesn't sound right, it sounds a little counterintuitive, but you run out of space to run the deep routes, so they can just sit on the shorter stuff if you're going to throw it. If you want to run it, it's just not as much space. They end up having to take 3 there.
First and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Second and 14. Fake the handoff. Now Tua. He's going to air one out. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Wilson. And a return across midfield into the 46-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Now a first down run is going nowhere. He's going to be dropped in the backfield, a loss of two.
Jerome Baker. This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. On the carry, Thompson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 12 yards there on a first down.
Brandon, I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
On first down, it's Thompson. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
He wants it all for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Nick Needham picks it off.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Now second and 7 from the 23. Off of play action, Tagovailoa. Got a man open, that's Devontae Parker complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 27 yards there, a first down.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game the play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
On second down, a run with Breida. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. The coverage unit out there thinking pass on 3rd and 3. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with Breida. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. The gain of 4 that time as the drive continues. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. The throw here caught by Devontae Parker. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play. Ready. 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 Ready.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. It's a solid pickup of 11, and it's second down.
At the 30-yard line.
Here's a toss right side for Breida. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down. So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. This is Breida. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown.
Touchdown.
Matt Breida with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Dolphins are going to jump back in front. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And looking at this situation, Charles, you got more than a minute. You've got all three timeouts. Probably no need to play this safe.
So what you're saying is that we're doing a little bit of a mind meld here, aren't we? Because I'm thinking along the same lines as you.
And this is going to be intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler, Byron Jones. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
Take over first and 10.
So that now two consecutive drives that have ended in interceptions. You wonder if he's trying to do a little too much out there.
Oh, I like where you're going with that. That maybe he's pressing it a little bit, trying to be too fine with his throws, or maybe overestimating his arm. It could be a combination of all those things. In any event, he's got to get it figured out and in a hurry.
45-yard line.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
Able to find Shaheen here. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
And it's third down.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. This play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. And a loss of three to bring up four. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. Now a timeout coming here defensively. As on fourth down, may as well make him punt it.
Field goal, a 32-yard attempt.
The kick by Sanders is good. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
First and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. On the handoff, this is Breda. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida with his third touchdown of the game, number 7 of the year. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. And the lead will grow by one more.
Makes the score Dolphins 24, Jaguars 10. Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Brings up second and 7.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Minshew. And he locates LaVisca Chenault, the rookie from Colorado. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
From the gun, Minshew to throw. Got his man, it's Eifert. 7 yards, the pickup there. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Working with a 2nd and 3.
Watch the run, watch the run. 6-6, pull it high.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Now, that was a designed run. Now, remember, if a quarterback goes feet first, he's protected. But if he dives head first, he's not. On that play, he figured the risk was worth the reward.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw to Thompson on the screen. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
Complete. Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 34-yard line. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Hand off to Thompson. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
First down. First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
70, Indy. I'm coming at the school. Hey, Mike 51, Mike 51. Squeeze, squeeze, double, double. 51, go.
Throwing on first down is Minshew. And the catch good. It's Eifert. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. There to make the grab. And the Jaguars are back within a score.
You got to figure down by the goal line. This is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
He's got it, and it's 24-17.
Makes the score Dolphins 24, Jaguars 17.
For the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
21-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
From the 25, here's second and 6. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Josh Allen in there to get him. It's a loss of 5. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Play action. Now it's Tua. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, DJ Hayden. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. Intercepted. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
Tackled by Jason Strobridge.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Again, a run with Thompson. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with 3rd down coming up.
Brings up 3rd and 2.
Minshew sets to throw. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. A rough go there on 3rd down, a loss of 4.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there defensively because they did everything as they would have wanted to. They forced a 3rd down, blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football, forced a dump off to the back, and even then they closed quickly and got it down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it, they did it well in that last sequence.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces them to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
Well, that holding call set them up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. They'll toss it to Breda. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. Back now in Jacksonville. It's Dolphin football. It's also Dolphin lead to begin quarter number 4. They run again with Breida. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
He's gonna go. They're not gonna get him. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida, 78 yards. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead.
Jason Sanders for the extra point.
You talk about the dominating rushing performances that you and I have seen together. This has got to be right up there. His 4th touchdown run of the game and another long one to boot.
And I don't need to ask for a witness because you're right here with me. We are watching this, and we're watching such a performance that is demoralizing for anyone on defense. You know, it starts out coaches screaming, tackle him, get him. And after that last touchdown, I'll bet it's pure silence on that side of the ball.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the 4th quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Minshew on 1st and 10. He'll rifle this from deep right side. And that's going to be intercepted by the Pro Bowler Xavier Howard. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch-counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
Nigel Bradham brings him down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now an open man. That's the tight end, Gesicki. It's complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 7 yards there and a 1st down. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the gun, it's Tua. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. Not much there, only a yard.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. The linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked by Jared Wilson, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Their own 11-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. The interception was a great starting point, but now they need points pretty quickly, down two scores. And the drive starts with a completion, left side. And he is finally out of bounds across midfield at the 40-yard line. A huge play there on the screen pass. 49 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. They toss it to Thompson. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
A loss of a yard brings up second and 11 at the 41 yard line.
On second and 11 now, Minshew. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Well, you won't hear any boos from this home crowd on that call.
No, not at all. And it's been a long day for this crowd waiting for this game. It's been a long evening as well. Finally, they feel they got a call.
Go now. Empty game.
Out of the gun is Minshew. Going for it all. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And they'll be down just outside of the end zone at the 1 yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out.
CJ.
Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down. Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate as they've got it first and 10 now out past the 20. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
Here's a quick hitch route and the throw complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Running out of the gun here, Breida. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first time out. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2 minute warning. The Dolphins on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Here's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 43. Tua finding Gesicki there for a Dolphin first. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. That one looks like he'll throw here. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki, and it's third down. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Fourth down.
And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. Sanders' kick is good, and that will get the lead up to 14. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it still ate up time, got points, so while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Second and 10.
Get ready, get ready, get ready. 51 to Mike, boy, 51.
Looking to throw it, Minshew. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
So third and long after the sack. Tough road for Minshew and the Jags. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And finding Keelan Cole. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber? I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go.
tonight.
So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the Dolphins, they get back in the win column as they move to 2-1 now on the year. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week where they take on the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they'll fall to 1-2. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in Cincinnati against the Bengals. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
For the wins, came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the wheel suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest of brand, but he falling again and again. I'm in the world. I'm in the game. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling the dust. You with it, so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
Me down. Nice like this, I wish I was richer. On my turf, roll out the Henry Rux. She like when I hit the receiver. Friend hopping, this is a four-seater. Made a yank straight up the wound, I'm Derek Jeter. Major Liga, no fatiga. We don't get no henna, we don't get no macarinas. If you gon' throw your back out trying to work, you'll need a breather.
I need a break.
Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me? Hold on. Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down.
Tell me who you talking to?
Roll up that Sinatra, fly la mama to the moon. She asked me what's my life path. Told her 55 south to the cat. So many couches I cracked. Shout out Zozo, Tree Tree, and Shout Classy.
Baby, I know you really wanna be my only woman. I need somebody to hold on to the sucker.
Game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winners on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it's stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows, I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gonna act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money, I'm out of that lane.